Explosions, gunshots, and an alarm echo throughout the quarantine zone.
Yeah, probably run to his house. It's around his.
It's by it's by your clinic. It's by your aunt, and it's by your apartment complex. That entire district is just you're honestly seeing these flickerings of flashes in the distance above the sky rise of the buildings in the QZ. There's a huge firefight, just concussing blasts everywhere. As you guys are running through the Black Market District and a few other of the checkpoints, you see that there are civilians scurrying, they're scattering, they're looking for the immediate or the closest shelter to them. As you hear on the megaphone, a mandatory curfew has been put into effect as people are they're scared and they're cowering in between these archways and in the doors, and they're looking to try and see what happens. You guys approach the home district. What seems to be a battlefield. There are squads of Fedra soldiers moving in and out. There are trucks, armored vehicles going in and out. You're still hearing the pop, 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 pop of things going on within this district. And there's a line of Fedra riot police as well that are holding the line there. Jude, as you kind of look past this barricade line, you see that your entire complex is engulfed in flames. As parts of the building are chipping off, as it seemed to receive damage from multiple sources there, as literally parts of it is crumbling off and just spurting into the streets.
I don't really have anything in there. You got an extra bed?
Yeah, if you need to, you can stay at the clinic for until you get reassigned somewhere.
Yeah, I think gonna be needing that real soon.
Kwabs, you see pretty close within, like around the rubble of that apartment complex that is ablaze, you see Fedra soldiers that are searching the ground with their flashlight. You hear someone in panic breaths as you see one of the fireflies crawling along the ground, wounded, just kind of scraping along the rubble as one of the Fedra soldiers comes up to him and his gun does not fire. As he starts laughing and taunting him, as this guy's trying to crawl as fast as he can to save his life, as the Fedra soldier then reloads, aims, and hits a bullet right in the back of this firefly's skull there. As then they say, scurry the rats, and they start moving throughout this district. Inara, you hear around the barricade that you're at now, the soldiers are like, clear out, get the fuck out of the way, move it! As they're opening up a gap, as then you then hear the roar of a mechanized engine unlike you've ever heard before, as it literally trembles the ground beneath you as pebbles start shaking, as a Fedra military tank rolls into this home district there, as this is the last operating mechanized tank of the US military, or at least in this district, as it goes in and it just crunches over all the rubble as it enters in, as you hear the turret. You're hearing communication combat there, as in they direct fire into one of the buildings as boom, as this thing fires, you all just, your ears start ringing. Cass, your ear honestly starts bleeding from that as it's just right next to you, this tank just fired through as the building next to this the Jude's apartment complex just obliterated, just a hole just bam out, as they're saying, level this place, as the tank goes deeper into this home district. Lastly, Cassie, you are looking around this area as there are wounded Fedra soldiers that are at a triage tent. You spot Sergeant Tomlin. Sergeant Tomlin's sitting there as he has a bandage wrapped around his eye, as his combat helmet next to him has a ballistic crack in it around the eye area on his like face shield. As he's sitting there.
Tomlin, what happened?
You go up to Tomlin, you start moving through Tomlin.
Yeah, I'm gonna go over and just try and like get inside his line of vision. What happened? Are you okay? Do you need anything?
As you guys are walking to Tomlin, you guys do get stopped by one of the Fedra riot soldiers who bumps both of you. What the fuck is this? Mandatory curfew. Get inside. You got something to hide, huh?
I just wanted to check on my friend. I know him.
Tomlin then, stand down, Private Jenkins. Let him through, as he then calls you up to him. Quite a day. hasn't it been?
Looks like it. What happened?
Looks like we found a nest of fireflies. They were ready, so were we. I don't know if you guys live in this district, but if you do, I recommend checking into the FEDRA relocation shelter. I don't think there's gonna be a home to come back to tomorrow.
Yeah, I can already see my door, my sink, fridge.
Don't worry, they'll take care of you. You won't be on the streets for too long.
Was anyone cleared out before this started? I mean, Inara lives right around here with her aunt. She doesn't.
I checked the triage center, and if not, I'm sorry. You guys hear the concuss of another tank shell. Just demolishing another building as it's now way deeper into that area. You hear...
How far is Cassie's...
Towards the back corner. So, a little bit deeper in. You don't have visibility of it yet.
Can I... I just want to try to make my way there.
How?
Like, maybe by picking around, like, the edges of the shadows or rubble or something. If the tank is the tank headed that way?
Yes, the tank is definitely headed in that direction.
Jude, do you know of any way to get back to the clinic without being seen? We have to go get her aunt out, or...
Yeah, I think I should.
Make a survival roll.
Do I?
What's up to this roll?
Six?
You know an above ground way to get back to the clinic. It's not directly down the street, or it's not an open field. You might be able to sneak past some of these guys, but you don't know at this time any of the secret, like, underground sewer kind of network things to pop up.
I'll take that. It's better than nothing.
Yeah. Just be careful, and, you know, you might slip and fall, so wouldn't want that. Is everyone coming?
Yeah, I'll come.
Yeah? All right. Just follow me. I don't know if there's a formation we do. Are we doing formations?
We'll just follow.
Okay. Yeah, this is. Okay.
As you guys are leaving Tomlin, you do see that his eye is basically shot out. Something went through his visor, and the shrapnel of the visor then took his eye out. It's honestly, you can kind of see some of the remnants of some of the eye gush just resin there. It's just bandaged up as he's fucked up. He looks to you before you go. We went back out and we swept that barricade. Found something of yours. He then opens up his vest and he straps out your knife. Thanks for the cigarettes.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Don't lose it again, because I don't think I'm going to be able to find it
easily. I'll come check on you after all this is over.
To keep an eye on it?
You guys, first make an elusive roll.
Is it a stealth roll?
Yes, you guys are kind of going around the side of the barricade here as there are federal operatives that are now moving into the district. You guys are kind of parallel to them, but you have to...
12.
I got 2, but my elusive is +2, so it's 4, plus the cold-blooded 5.
Okay, DC 20, you guys make it. You guys are looping around. You have a little bit of a heart attack there as one of the FEDRA operatives sees you, but says, get the fuck back, there's a mandatory curfew.
Oh, sorry, yeah, my house got blown up. Not a problem.
Not my problem. You guys then rake it to the ledge there, as you can see that about 10 feet in the air, there is a ledge that you guys can then grapple onto. You can boost up.
Hey, Cassie, boost me up.
Okay. Brutality, elusive.
8.
Oh, 5.
Step on it, boom, flings up, you grapple up.
What are you doing?
Pull yourself up?
I can't.
What?
I can't pull myself up.
Why?
The fuck do you mean you can't pull yourself up, Jude?
I didn't work out. Nah, I'm just kidding, Kwabs. I'm just kidding. I'm just trying to light
it. Not the time to joke right now.
You know, I get that told a lot.
All four of you are up on this roof as you guys pull each other up. You guys have a clear view of this first part of the district. You'll need to cross over a block to get to the clinic's area. You do see scattered soldiers patrolling everything. They're knocking in doors and then throwing in frag grenades and Molotov cocktails as they're just. as the tank is rolled by on its way towards the clinic as well.
Okay, I know before it was infected and then people that were trying to kill us. We might have to, and as I'm doing this, I would like to craft a ship. So we might have to kill, you know, somewhat more innocent people. If they see us, we're probably gonna get shot. These might be people you know, people, you know, you may have yourself, Cassie, attended to. These are just, I know they're FEDRA, but they're basically other citizens like us, right? But if that's what we're trying to do, and if you get caught, just, you know, be aware of that.
You guys, basically, you have another platform, another roof, that's about one story tall. You're two stories up right now. Two goes to one, and then to the ground floor. There's a FEDRA armored vehicle there, as it seems that the soldiers that are closest to it are scanning the grounds there in the rubbles. There are bodies littered of civilians that were caught in the crossfire as well. As they're trying to package and triage. There's some FEDRA medics themselves.
Could we sneak through these corpses, like kind of crawl prone?
Is there a way to get down on that roof? The one story roof?
Can I do an instinct roll to try to kind of gauge if there's any other FEDRA guys near us at least, or try to see if there's people around
roll
us?
It.
Five.
You hear some chatter from what seems to be two soldiers that are approaching that general vicinity.
Like, is there like a ladder or something we could get down to that first level floor?
Make a scavenging roll.
Or would
roll.
It be like... Seven?
You do find a ladder on this roof. Seems
I'm,
that there was...
I'm going to try to get the ladder over the side so we can get down and try to put it as much in the shadows as possible so it's not super obvious.
You do so. There's also a couple other construction tools up here as well. It seems like they were maybe repairing a roof from some rain damage.
May I scavenge?
Scavenge.
You can. Also like to scavenge.
You two find nothing? Did you find a wrench?
Who's going down first?
I'll go down first. We have to get there. We have to move.
Yeah, go. I'll hold the ladder.
Can we take the ladder that we used to get down here and use it to get...
You absolutely can. Okay, you place that ladder. When you guys go down this first time, now you're going to need to make your first stealth roll.
Okay.
Before we go down, I want to see if I can scavenge a bottle or a brick and kind of stay up there and act as like overwatch. If you get caught, I can throw something.
There's nothing up here.
Good luck.
Who's going first?
Not me. I'll go first.
What did you get?
10.
Great. Let's start with that, Cassie. Inara, you go down the ladder and you're now on that ground floor in the shadows. Only the moonlight and the flames from the buildings are illuminating you right now or exposing your position. Now, Cassie.
I hope it's better than that last one.
I hope so, too.
Two.
The ladder tips and hits the ground as you hit the ground. It seems that besides a medic kind of looking up, everyone's preoccupied. The ladder has fallen, though, where it is in view of these soldiers now.
How high up are we?
One story, about 15 feet.
Am I able to kind of break my fall? Are there any pipes or anything? Could I kind of...
You want to kind of climb down?
So what...
Oh, Jesus.
Jutes is going to be on the floor of the roof.
You hit the ground. The crate breaks underneath your feet as it seems to be weathered and deteriorated. As the loud crash of wood, one of the medics stands up and walks towards you three.
Does it seem like they saw us or they just heard a weird noise?
They heard a noise from behind the truck, pretty much.
Jude is going to, since he's up there, he's going to look at Cassie. He's going to take out a shiv and just be like,
the medic walks around the truck, headlights, as you see them, as this male medic makes eye contact with all three of you attempting to hide. As there's this moment of stillness, one of the soldiers in the back, what the fuck's a holdup? As the medic move. Nothing, it was nothing, all right? It was nothing, all right? I just thought I heard something. As he then goes back to triaging the bodies. Jude.
Wait a minute! Now see, I hope I get a nat one, so I just go like, look. Go, get out of there!
And then the soldier's like, Firefly! You three are at the other side of the truck.
Wait, Jude, wait!
I'm, go ahead. Can I hold my action to wait for Jude?
Okay, 8.
You basically wrap around, you kind of try and parkour down, as then you kind of jump, and Cassie fumbles the fold. Last stealth roll.
Fuck me.
11.
Crit.
Ooh.
What? Dane's like, that wasn't enough.
It seems there was a very intense battle here. It seems that this was almost a ground zero for one of the conflicts. Is from the front side of this clinic, part of the building is caved in. It's you would judge it as this would be probably where your office part is. At least where your office was. You have your lobby, then you have your check-in room, and then you have your office and storage supplies. This part of the building is completely rubbled down. There are scorch marks. There is a fire kind of creeping towards it. Bullet holes all throughout the wall, blood stains all throughout the wall. There are many, many soldiers out here. It seems that there was a big battle as a tank is slowly approaching the clinic area as well as it is now blowing up the building that's across the street from it.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get to the front door as soon as possible and get the lock undone so we can get inside.
Okay, you guys creep up to the side of that alley there. You have your key?
Yeah, I would have that on me.
You unlock your clinic door? As the clinic door opens through, you hear an echo as your foot immediately steps on some rubble. As there is scattered debris all throughout this lobby area here. No lights are on, there's no power, but there is what seems to be moonlight peering through and beaming from the check-in room here. As you can kind of, you're in this dim area, seems that there's a light towards the check-in room where your aunt is.
Can I run towards it without...
Yes.
I run towards it.
You step over this rubble as it starts to pile up a little bit more as you look into the check-in room and there is a crater above the ceiling there as the moonlight's peering through as it's shining down directly on your aunt on the waiting table, which is buried underneath debris and rubble as the only thing that you see from her is her hand kind of outwardly clenched outside of that debris.
I'm just gonna run and I'm gonna grab her hand. And I'm just gonna just like be whispering like, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I didn't make it back, I'm so sorry.
The three of you enter as well. Do you unbury her?
Can I? Yeah.
Do you guys help? You guys take the rubble off and you're separated as you reveal your aunt. She doesn't look in agony. She looks almost at peace. It was quick. And she did not suffer anymore. Her eyes are already closed as well.
Just gonna hold her. I'm just gonna hold her.
Cassie, make an instinct check. Kwabs, Jude, make an instinct check.
12.
11.
3.
Cassie, as you are comforting Inara and your clinic is completely destroyed, you do see a blood trail that's fresh that is on the ground that seems to be going around the corner towards the bathrooms. Jude, you also see this.
Jude's gonna kinda like keep close to and point out the blood and be like, come with me. Yeah. And Jude's gonna, actually no, it's loud. He's gonna take out his little shiv and just be like, I'll be right back.
Creep, as you follow this blood trail, as it kind of leaves this check-in waiting room, as it enters one of the clinic's bathrooms, the blood trail grows larger and larger and larger as it now is immediately around the corner.
Can I make an instinct roll to maybe get a idea that maybe if someone might be around the corner?
Roll it.
It's a 4. What the fuck is up with my rolls today?
What you know is that the bathroom is small, and right when you turn that corner, you'll be face to face with whatever is there, alive or dead.
Okay. Is anyone in there? All right, take that as a yes. FEDRA, are you one of the terrorists?
You're hearing scattered breathing, almost as if it's a struggle to talk.
We got a doctor here that'll probably be able to help you out. Throw down your gun and more than happy to help you out.
You do hear the slide of a wood gun just around the corner. It's not able to reach around the corner, but you do hear that sliding motion of a weapon.
Okay, so I'm gonna come in, all right? I'm gonna have my gun drawn again, just precaution. I'm pretty sure you do the same thing. Not gonna shoot you. But yeah, I'm gonna come in with my gun, probably pointing at you again. Don't shoot, just precaution. All right, wish me luck, right?
We are behind you.
Nice. Count of 3, all right? 1, 2, 3.
As you, there's not a flinch as you go around the corner. There, the moonlight's almost able to illuminate this area of this dark bathroom. As you see a man, he's laying on the ground as he's slumped up against what little stall there is. As you just see that his stomach is just opened up with a bullet wound. It literally, blood is oozing through his fingers as we speak. You see he's wearing a brown flannel and an olive green thing, and you immediately identify the Firefly band around his arm.
Got ourselves a Firefly.
Was she family?
Not to me. But, yeah.
What the hell happened?
No one deserves to lose their family. Please help me. I'll make it worth your while, I promise.
Well, to start off, you gotta get that shit off of you. All of us will die if that shit's on you. We have to get that off of you. It might be painful, but we're gonna have to get that jacket off of you, too.
I'm just gonna kill you anyways. What do you guys do with? He's about to enter unconsciousness right now.
Could we do something with that kind of patch, or maybe kind of?
Not big enough.
Fuck.
You're gonna need a doctor.
Bandages and bandages. Do I yell for?
Yeah. Well,
she is comforting Inara, but maybe I could kind of run back in and kind of just like.
I'm gonna just like give Inara's hand a squeeze and then go around the corner. See what I can do.
We'll be right here if you need us.
Make a medicine check. Your flashlight reveals more of the wounds as well.
Oof. 10.
Internal hemorrhaging, and he's basically fucked up. If you don't help him, he will die.
Gotta use it on him.
Well, yeah. Let's think. Judah's gonna... Hey. Just out of your shot. Firefly, right? He's already dying.
We're all already dying. What does that mean?
I'm just saying, again, I'm not saying we shouldn't, but do we really want to be caught with another firefly, I guess?
Well, he's not a firefly with that shit on him. He could be anybody now.
True, but...
Caught in the crossfire, you throw that shit off in the rubble.
Do you trust him?
He could help us. Maybe he knows something that we deserve to know.
That's true.
That was you on the floor, you'd want someone to help you, wouldn't you?
Oh yeah, because it's me.
So put yourself in his shoes.
I have one medicine. I guess I can just hand it off to him. Or cast.
Be cast to administer with that 10. Okay, you volunteer your very valuable resource. Cassie, you patch him up.
As I finish, I'm just gonna pass him a Jolly Rancher because it's not much, but it'll keep you going for a little bit.
What's your name?
John. Who do I have the pleasure?
I'm Kwabs.
Why does that name sound familiar?
What are you talking about?
What's your full name?
Why does that matter? Why are you asking me for my full name?
Just curious.
It's Quabina Adekunye.
Your sister Deej?
The fuck do you know about my sister Deej? She's dead.
She ain't dead. She's a firefly. She's a hell of a fighter.
Shut the fuck up.
I'm serious.
Shut the fuck up.
How would I know that? She talked about you.
She's dead. Don't get to mention her fucking name.
Understood.
Now I helped you from bleeding out. Don't make me undo it. Don't mention her fucking name again.
Alright. What's your name?
Cassie,
nice to meet you. I'm sorry for your loss.
I'm just gonna look over my shoulder. Were you here?
I found her like this, I swear. It's a firefight out front. Lost all my men. You're looking at the last firefly. We've heard rumors of a community doctor helping people. Stealing medicine illegally from FEDRA and giving it to the people. Is a firefly in you yet?
There's not much I can do now without a place to work out of.
Might be able to help you as payment. We can't make any moves right now. We have to stay here until it's safe. I recognize your fringes.
And you guys didn't believe me.
When FEDRA pulled up this morning, we thought it was for us. Turned out it was for you. I'm sorry about your friend.
He ratted me out. Got what he deserved.
Seems like there's a lot of rats in this city. You hear movement outside of the clinic as you hear that engine of the tank pull up. As seems to stop outside as there's debate on what to do here as the tank fires and the building right next to the clinic. You feel it. You all kind of drop as boom, as part of the ceiling starts rumbling in. Inara, you brace over your aunt as some of the rubble hits you. As the rubble then hits you instead, it bounces off of your jacket as you then hear the turret. Everybody make a survival roll. As the tank shell blasts through the clinic, as the debris, the hole just opens up as debris and rubble goes flying everywhere as you guys are all sent to the floor.
8.
Crit.
4.
Unnatural 10.
The blast. Everything is blurry and spinning as you guys lay on the back as you see the stars of the sky now and the flames of the buildings around you as there are piles of rubble as nothing stands of this clinic as the hole has just been blown over. There's like a hail, there's like a mound of that wall that was caved in protecting your guys' field of view as you lay on your backs as dust clogs your guys' lungs as you cough. Jude is unconscious. As he's face down in the rubble, as John crawls up to Jude. You guys then see peering over that mound of rubble, the beams of flashlights, and the sounds of footsteps as soldiers are beginning to investigate this thing. Make a medicine roll on Jude.
10.
Smelling salts. Something. You do something. Jude, you pop up. Shut the fuck up.
Oh, shit.
As you guys are literally belly down as this mound of rubble and these flashlights are almost upon you. What is your move?
Did we just get totally blasted away?
This clinic is demolished, yes.
So my aunt is nowhere near me anymore.
In a different pile of rubble somewhere else, yes.
I
to what I know, secret alleys, smuggling alleys.
He does.
Oh, okay, cool.
Get to the alleyway below. Be quiet. Are you all right? I think. Are you alive?
Oh boy.
Go, move.
Seven. Is it a stealth roll?
It is a stealth roll.
13.
Six.
Seven.
Stealthily creep across this rubble. Cassie and Kwabs, you guys are a little bit slower as you guys are trying to get your bearings among this rubble as one of the Fedra soldiers stands up as a shiv goes through this Fedra soldier's neck as John has come there, dug it in, and then like hushed him as he was dying. You guys then are ushered over to the side here as the soldiers, they don't know what happened to their friend. The body, he drops it down and even covers it a little bit with some of that rubble, concealing it. As you guys move to this alleyway around the corner, you have a couple rounds here. There is a fire escape up on this alley, right above the dumpster, which the guy was hiding behind earlier.
I'm gonna try and get that ladder down so we can...
Scavenging roll.
8.
The dumpster should do it. Perfect. You can move the dumpster into position. You could climb it on that way.
Perfect. Yeah, I'm gonna move the dumpster in position and then climb up on top of it to get onto that first level.
You guys ascend. You kind of cut through a couple buildings. You guys make it to the ruins of a building on one of these outer QZs as he moves open a cabin that he, like, it's almost like a secret entrance. As he pushes it aside, there's a crack within this drywall that you can then kind of shimmy on through. If you trust me, then go.
Yeah.
You guys shimmy through and it's pitch black. Pitch black as you're shimmering through as you don't know if you can trust this man or not. As you seem to enter a dark building, a dark room, John seems to hit a light switch. Very faint and dim flickering bulbs. Surrounding you is scattered supplies. There are tattered Firefly banners. There are boards with maps of the QZ with circles of checkpoints and Fedra movements. There's a medical ward that seems to have equipment that you can't fathom. They have IVs. They have a heartbeat meter. They have a portable generator in here that starts to hum as he flicks it on. I think we should be safe here.
What's your next move? You said you were the last one.
I can leave it all to you. You're gonna need a place for continue to do the people's work.
What?
Fireflies are done here. I've got a radio signal from our leader in the Boston QZ that something big is going down. I'll be leaving in the morning.
So you're just giving up on us? You're just giving up on all of these people here?
There are many QZs. I've been fighting Fedra for nearly 8 years at this point. Sometimes you need to know when to regroup. I promise you payment. He gives each of you a flashlight that didn't have one already.
Thank you.
Why is mine so small?
He gives you all a military-grade gas mask.
John. How do you know my sister?
I thought I wasn't allowed to mention it anymore.
It makes no fucking sense. She left a note when I was 17 that she'd leave. She promised that we'd run away together. Things just went bad after that. My father fell in a deep depression, started drinking. They were strict, right? They always kept a close eye on me and my sister Deej, and you know, It slipped him. Started falling into crime. Black market. Started doing things that I thought I never would with my sister around, and he started drinking. Found him dead with a bottle in his hand, and not long after, my mom started to forget things. She forgot who Khadija even was. You know, she left a note after she promised that we'd run away together, maybe find solitude elsewhere, outside of a QZ, and now you're telling me she's a Firefly.
We all got war stories. Each of us scarred in our own way. I only know of Deej from the Freedom Fighter. I'm sorry she didn't tell you, and I'm sorry that she hurt you. If any of you want to put your skills to a greater use, if you ever want to see your sister again, he then goes to his cabinet or his the war desk there where they had all the maps. As he jots one down, as he hands it to you. If you ever not want to worry about food, life without FEDRA, there are good people trying to make something of this world. This map will take you to our base out west. I can loop back here after whatever goes down in Boston. I just can't take new recruits now.
How much of this stuff are you packing back to Boston?
It's all yours. Take this. If you ever make it to that base, give this to them. That's mine. It's got my name on it. They'll let you in. They won't shoot you. And remember that there's always hope. He gives this to Inara. You know, one of our Fireflies says that a girl with a wrench helped them, gave them running water. Your work, both of you, has not gone unnoticed. Thank you.
John, I apologize for going off on you like that. Just no one has ever said my sister's name other than myself.
Know that she still loves you. Because she talked about you a lot.
If she loved me, she wouldn't have fucking left. But I appreciate you at least giving me some sort of inkling that she ain't dead. For what it's worth.
Cassie's just gonna go over and sit by Jude for a while, and I don't think she really says anything. Just kind of like nudges your shoulder and passes you a Jolly Rancher and goes, hey, just remember to keep a smile on your face every once in a while.
Yeah. And then he's gonna reach in his pocket and take out one he already had. I think you need one too.
John seems to have packed his bags as he loads his rifle as he heads towards the back exit. Thank you for finding a good fight, all of you. As John slips into the night,